Our African ancestors, brothers and sisters, saw the matrilineal system. Keep in mind that all the kings had to come through the line of the woman. Is that right?
That's right.
What man can say he didn't come from a woman? Please step forward so we can understand where you came from. So our ancestors had no problems understanding that divine principle of that sacred womb where we all came from. That was the basis and foundation of the goddess principle and the matrilineal system in Africa. And our ancestors saw, in order for the king to rule the throne, like you have Ursa Maatra here, the goddess Shishat. Here you see her in the tree of divine wisdom, giving the fruit of divine knowledge and wisdom in order for him to rule the throne. It had nothing to do with no tree of good and evil. The patriarchs who came from the north, the Hyksos and others, who had a misogynistic nature, a hatred towards the woman, could not conceive of a woman nor a goddess giving a man anything. And that story was corrupted. The tree of divine wisdom and divine life was corrupted into the tree of what? Because here we have that they created in their biblical stories and the opening of the pages in Genesis that there was Adam and Eve, is that right?
That's right.
And they were not to eat of the tree of what?
Blood.
Knowledge of what?
Good and evil.
Good and evil. Now who was seduced by the serpent and ate from the tree? That's why, sisters, you gotta watch and you hear that sound. Psst. But anyway, here we see that she was seduced to eat the fruit, and then she seduced who?
Adam.
Now we are told that that's the reason for the world's sins of this first woman eating of the tree of good and evil, and that that's also not only the reason for the world's sins, but her monthly cycle is to remind her of that sin. This is what's taught in the church. Okay? Now when sisters start jacking that preacher up, who's been equally spiritually enslaved himself to tell that story, and that we were born in sin, there was no story whatsoever in the Kemetic Nile Valley that we were born in sin. So a few years ago, back in 1988, boy, time is fast. Seemed like I just got this yesterday. Brother and sister showed me, they said, hey, brother, Kwesi, you see, there was a black Adam and Eve. Although they made a black Adam and Eve, that has nothing to do with our story. This is what we see the evolutionists and creationists fighting each other, and they know anthropological studies that black people were first, so they put a black Adam and Eve and gave Adam a jerry curl and gave Eve a weave. You know, they had to be looking good for each other back then, you know. But it had nothing to do with our story, brothers and sisters. Even though they make it black to make you accept it, this is not still an African story. The African story is the goddess Shishat giving the fruit of divine life from the tree of divine life and wisdom in order for the king to rule the throne. And this goddess concept was corrupted throughout the whole African Nile Valley and even in our spiritual subconscious, even today, where we are told that the sisters are the ones, women are the ones for the world's sins. This is the demonization of women and the hatred of women. This is part of the sexism that you get in the theologians. Even in Paul, it says that women shouldn't even speak in the church. But I'm letting you know that that is not the African spiritual way, brothers and sisters. We had a god and a goddess. That's a spiritual Maatian law that our ancestors saw. Okay? So let's understand that there was no rib, by the way, in the African creation story taken from the man to make the woman. That didn't exist. They were created simultaneously. So we did not have no story, but all of us got a navel where the umbilical cord was severed from our mothers, where we all came from. But until we get back to the true spirituality of understanding our divine balance of African men and African women, we'll forever be a victim in somebody else's racist theological story and the victimization of sisters where we cannot see our divine balance in the universe. Hotel. And you know the story is corrupted anyway because as they said, there was only Adam and Eve, and then they created a son named who?
Cain and Abel.
And Cain went out to the land of Nod and found what? They haven't been able to explain that story yet. And then the racist theologians will tell you that was the sub-Negroid race. No, African people had a great kingdom long before their Adam and Eve story that they created and corrupted from the goddess Aset and Asar from right here in Kemet, right here in Egypt where you are, these stories are told. This is a book in stone. That's why they carved endlessly so it could not be revised. You see the ark already back there. How could the Ark of Covenant, that the Jews say that Jehovah God is the portable God house, and you got it right here.
That they're carrying.
And we are taught to go to Jerusalem and not to come back here to Kemet. We look at Jerusalem as being the Holy Land, not Kemet as being the Holy Land. This was the original Holy Land. This was the original Tineter Land. I know that may be hard for some of us, but 400 years of indoctrination, you have to look at yourself as a victim. And we have been a victim. But we have continuous stories. So this is a book in stone. You can have a few minutes to take your pictures of the goddess Yeshat and go back and tell the story. Show it to the preachers. Show it to the ministers. We want to get to the root of these stories, and you've come halfway around the world, back to the African Nile Valley, and witnessed where they've copied and manipulated these stories from you. We want to get to the root of the story, and the root of the story was no Eve, but it was, in fact, Shishak giving divine knowledge and wisdom. See, the only story that we have when a story regurgitates up is what white folks put in our psyche. But now the real psychological warfare is going to take place now because you are here. Yes. You're witnessing on the temples now, Shishak and the Tree of Life and many other concepts that we have shown, and that's down in your psyche. So when you hear the Garden of Eden, what's going to trigger in your mind right back here? I saw Shishak.
Right.
And it was nothing. That's what's going to trigger. That's what's going to activate.
Right.
But if you have nothing down in your psychic to fight that,
right,
then you can only accept that which has been told to you.
Mm-hmm.